Once you master that level of detachment, all areas of your life are going to improve. Hey, we're going to the cafe. About this spiritual journey that if you're watching this video, you're probably on. It's hard because especially with social media, TikTok, books, and YouTube videos and all the different creators that have a different perspective on the same things, it gets confusing when you have so much content that you're watching and listening to in order to try and better yourself. So I'm in a place where I'm organizing my thoughts and organizing the information that I'm looking into to see what best suits me. And right now, what I'm focusing on is the art of detachment. So I'm going to sit here and read a little bit, and then I am going to get into it when I get in my car, just because it's a little chilly out here and windy, so.
This shit right here, nigga? This shit right here, nigga? The book that I'm almost done reading, which is The Art of Seduction by Robert Greene, this book is amazing. Not only is the information in the book amazing, but the way that it is written is so amazing. It's kind of like a period piece at the same time, because it explores a lot of stories written in the 1800s and the early 1900s in regards to seduction and power and how they use their seduction type to be able to influence people to do things that they want to do.
For me, the first place that I need to start and the first pillar of this whole process that I need to focus on in order to be able to move forward with confidence and being happy and not feeling like, oh my God, my manifestation isn't here. What I desire is not here yet. It's not working. It's not this. It's not that. The first thing that I need to do is to detach. And to detach, it means to detach from the idea of the outcome. All of these methods of being able to transform your life and transform your mind, what I realized is the precipice of all of these methods is detachment. Because with detachment comes a very strong urge to control the circumstances, you know? And that's the thing. We cannot change our circumstances, but we can focus on what we can control. Our perspective, our words, our reactions, our thoughts, and our attention. So that's where I'm starting. That is where I'm starting. I'm starting on looking at things from a different perspective, a perspective that makes me feel good. You know, sometimes you look at your circumstances and you're like, what the fuck? Look at the cards that I was dealt. How am I supposed to navigate this world when I have all of these things weighing on me? You know how you do that? Through detachment, okay? There are a whole bunch of different areas where detachment comes in handy. So the areas that detachment comes in handy is detachment to material things, detachment in relationships, detachment from your thoughts, and detachment from your experiences. So for me, the most important place for me to start based on where I am right now is to detach from my experiences. We all go through different things, and with detachment, detaching from these experiences, you allow yourself to not be weighed down by the things that you've been through in the past. You know what I mean? Because the past really and truly does not exist. The only reason that the past exists for me is because I keep visiting it. I keep trying to look back and say, oh my God, I'm feeling like this. I can't believe that I went through this, and I can't believe that like this happened to me. And it really just puts me in the mind state like I'm never going to be able to move past this, which is why I have been really practicing detaching from that and being present every day and doing the best that I can with the present moment. The only place that you can control and the only thing that you can control, like I said, is what you do in this present moment. And every time you make a great decision, every time you do what feels right, you're getting a step closer to being able to manifest the life of your dreams. So detachment in relationships. There are, as we know, the four different attachment styles. I used to identify with the anxious attachment style. That arose from different experiences that I had in my childhood. Awareness is the first step, right? So in regards to detachment in relationships, it's very necessary because it allows you to not take things personal. When you are attached in relationships, every single thing that that person does, you feel like they're doing it to hurt you or doing it purposefully. And yes, that may not be true, but do you want to allow that person to have that much control over your emotions and your thoughts? And the way that you feel about yourself? No, I don't want that. So we detach, babes. Another reason why detachment in relationships is important is because you don't seek validation. You don't need that person. You don't need them to tell you you're beautiful. You don't need them to tell you that you're worthy. You know that already. You don't need them to do those things, which is why seeking validation, you'll never, ever, ever feel whole, because you're going to be relying on other people to justify you and to make you feel good. And that ain't good. Okay. Love is acceptance and not control. So that means accepting that person for who they are, the way they are, and loving them as is, and appreciating them for who they are, and not loving them based on a you do like a tit for tat basis. Like, I'm only going to love you if you do this. I'm only going to love you if you buy me this. I'm only going to love you if you pay for every day. I'm only going to love you if you do. That's not love. And I don't want to be loved that way. So I wouldn't do that to anybody else. You know what I'm saying? So the next form of detachment that we're going to talk about is detaching from material goals. Detachment from material goals basically means that it's not that you don't own anything. It's that nothing owns you. And when you attach to the money in a bank account, the type of apartment you want, anything less than that, you're going to feel less than, because you set a goal and you didn't hit that goal. You didn't get exactly what that thing is. And when you get it, what happens when you get something that you really want? You then move on to something else that is even bigger, that's even better. You know what I mean? There's nothing outside of you that should be defining who you are. To me, the next one is the most important, which is detachment from your own thoughts, right? This is achieved usually through meditation, sitting and being aware with yourself and being able to sit in silence. Looking at your thoughts as an outsider, which basically means when your thoughts arise, you let them pass. You don't engage with them. You don't associate with them. You don't attach to them, because thoughts are fleeting. And let's be for real. Not all thoughts are important, and neither are they truth or reality. They're just thoughts. So it's like, if I attach myself to every thought that I had, I would go fucking mad, bro. Especially when things are not going well in life and it's like you're not feeling too great about it. Do you really want to attach to those negative thoughts? Is that really who you think you are? And I feel like detaching from your thoughts allows you so much more space in your mind to be able to focus on who you truly are. I saw this thing. I heard somebody say that we think something like a billion thoughts a fucking day. Let me look it up. Bro, every day your brain processes about 70,000 thoughts. Imagine attaching yourself to even half of those thoughts. 35,000 thoughts? I don't even want to attach myself to 10% of those thoughts. I don't want to attach myself to anything that I'm thinking, because I'm not always thinking in a positive way. The only thing certain about life is uncertainty. So being able to, by detaching, you allow yourself to be flexible and you allow yourself to flow with the current of life. Detach from the outcome and focus on the process. Be present. Feel truly in your heart that you are deserving and capable of having this thing. Feel good about that. Know that. Just know it. You know, you don't know when, you don't know how, and you don't know why, but let's say you have an idea to have this thing. Detach from that and focus on what's in front of you. Trust, have faith.